The name of this video is Slavery via Brain Stimulation with Electromagnetic and Acoustic Weapons by Skizit Gesture. This video is about assault with electromagnetic and acoustic weapons to injure, control, and kill human beings. Just like your fingerprint, you have unique patterns of electromagnetic activity in your brain and body. These are called electric resonance frequencies. Resonance is how fast or slow vibrations repeat or cycle. Through resonance, a comparatively weak vibration in one object can cause a strong vibration in another, which can be damaged or destroyed. Your unique resonance frequencies can be used to calibrate a supercomputer and then used to radiate you with harmful frequencies that can damage your DNA and destroy your cells. It's important to protect your frequencies so they're not stolen by people who want to harm you. How a person who has your frequencies can control and punish you as if you were a slave. There are 5 brainwave frequency bands. Gamma, over 30 Hz. Beta, 13 to 30 Hz. Alpha, 8 to 12 Hz. Theta, 4 to 8 Hz. And Delta, less than 4 Hz. A hertz is cycles per second and named after Heinrich Hertz, who proved electromagnetism in 1886. New technologies have proven that movements, sensations, emotions, desires, ideas, and a variety of psychological phenomena may be induced, inhibited, or modified by electrical stimulation of specific areas of the brain. For clarity, an electrocardiogram, EKG, is a test for the electrical activity of the heart. An electroencephalogram is a test that measures and records the electrical activity of your brain. Evoked potentials can also be recorded from the brain. An evoked potential shows what the brain does after it's stimulated by the senses, such as sight, sound, pain, pleasure, heat, or cold. You can tell what a person is feeling by studying these frequencies. Patterns show that a person's brain frequencies can be used to place sounds or voices inside their head, so that they are the only one to hear the sound. This is a harassment tool being used on targeted individuals. The frequencies stimulate the auditory cortex in the brain, not the ears. Everyone has their own unique brain code, so frequencies must be calculated and calibrated for each individual. Controlling another person's mind is very much like slavery, so acquiring someone's brain-specific code for the purpose of harming them must be done in secret. One way to get electronically induced sounds in your brain is for your government to give you a free mobile electroencephalogram, recording and stealing the unique signature of electrical activity of neurons in your brain without your knowledge or consent. They may use a meter made specially for this purpose, or they may use an app for phones which records your unique frequencies by pointing the device at the back of your head. Many people think this is impossible, but the perpetrators have been able to rely on disbelief and a lack of public education to keep this technology a secret. An example of this is in an article called Remote Detection of Human EEG Using Ultra-High Input Impedance Electric Potential Sensors, written by Terry Clark in Sussex in 1986. When do you get your free brain frequency recording? When you relax, maybe when you're out shopping or eating, but you may never know when it's done. The new battlefield is the supermarket. When you're checking out at the grocery store, beware of anyone behind you pointing a meter or a phone at you. Sometimes people have meters under their clothing, as you will see in a minute. The following is a recording of the theft of brain frequencies which occurred at Panera's restaurant on January 29, 2013 at 8:45 a.m. in Springfield, Missouri. Organized Stalkers 1 and 2. Boy 1 and Boy 2 came into Panera's restaurant together, but they sat on opposite sides of their target. Please note that neither one of them has purchased food or drink. You have to assume they came in the restaurant for the purpose of performing a job. Boy 2 is in the middle of the picture. He sat in front of his target with a computer, and Boy 1 sat behind the same target with a phone. Boy 2 notices his target has a camera on him, and he signals to Boy 1 to abort their mission. Boy 1 never looks up from his phone and doesn't realize he's being videoed. Watch what he does. He points the phone up to the back of his target's head. Right here. He continues this for about a minute and a half to 2 minutes. And that's it. Except for picking his nose. Boy 2 continues trying to attempt to abort and remains focused on their target.
Once they have your brain frequencies, they can calibrate their EG supercomputer and begin enslaving you with radio, microwave, and acoustic frequencies, ultrasound, and infrasound. They can use your body's frequencies to stop your bodily functions, your bowels, and urination. Your whole nervous system can be made to vibrate. Voice to skull. Voice to skull is one of the most disturbing ways to harass people because only the victim hears the voices. Most cultures attribute inner voices either as a sign of madness or a message from spirits or demons, both of which evoke powerful emotional reactions. If someone doesn't know about this technology beforehand, they might think they're going crazy, which gives the bad guys a reason to put them in a mental institution. Police and doctors are using their powers as a harassment tool meant to remove targeted individuals from society by giving them a record of mental illness. The following are more examples of stalkers gathering frequencies or information using handheld devices. Stalker number 3. The Gangstalker trying to get your frequency may be a cop.
He approaches his target 3 times. If it was legal, he could just ask you for your brain code. He's engaged in torture and murder.
He's adjusted his radio and parks his backside with the radio facing the back of his target's head for 2 minutes. Then he's gone with his partner in crimes against humanity. Note that this is a stalking posture. The stalker sneaks in behind their target without the target's knowledge. This girl takes a seat behind her target on a window ledge. It's freezing outside and there are plenty of seats. It looks like she's just using her phone until she points it at the back of her target's head. She's done.
Stalker number 5.
In a restaurant, the stalker will enter after the target finds a place to sit. They also don't make eye contact like normal people do when they are right next to someone. He placed his phone on the bench, pointed straight at his target.
Stalker number 6.
What is this man doing?
Just shopping? Look where he positions himself in relation to his target's head. The target is sitting on a wooden bench. He has something under his sweater in the middle of his back. It takes a few seconds to get into position. Puts the bump under the sweater right to the back of the target's head. Avoid anyone getting your personal frequencies by knowing what to look for. Within hours subsequent to the theft of your brain frequencies, you might hear a voice call your name, but it's not a sound heard in your ears. It is in the auditory cortex of your brain, and no one hears it but you. It may be a sound like an animal, such as a cat hissing the word meow like a demon. Some hear suggestions and criticisms of their thinking or actions. Others hear threats of being murdered if they don't pay the perpetrators money. Some hear pornography or cursing. Some are told to commit acts of violence or suicide. Your throat may make sounds all by itself, which is called involuntary vocalization. Your voice can be artificially stimulated with radio frequencies between 20 Hz and 20,000 Hz. This is used to cause sleep deprivation in targeted individuals. A targeted individual is someone who is put into a harassment program. They suffer from organized stalking, radiation, Morgellons, sometimes all three. IHOP is partnered with the Justice Department in a program called COPS, which runs the Stalker radiation on TIs. The IHOP staff are notified that the TIs at the restaurant, and they give them stale, nasty food and extra slow service. IHOP gang stalks.
Other restaurants partnering with the fusion centers in harassing and gang stalking are Arby's, Ruby Tuesdays, BJ's Brewhouse, Dickie's Barbecue, and Panera. Often, TIs become sick, lose their jobs, lose their homes, and become alienated from their families, who are also attacked drugland style just for being related to them. When they try to get help, they are accused of being mentally ill because their story seems so outrageous.
What's happening to targeted individuals? Their homes are destroyed. Lasers have burned the floor. Some have had magnetrons installed nearby or in their attics to radiate them with microwaves. Magnetrons are extremely heavy because of the magnets inside. They generate microwaves that can cause cataracts, blindness, and other physical symptoms. Here's the structure of a magnetron. TIs are targeted with frequencies 24 hours a day. The following are injuries of an elderly woman who lives alone. This is an eye hit with a laser. These are injuries from a laser from outside this victim's house using see-through technology. These are shoulder and arm injuries from late.
Some are used for sex and then thrown away. And then there are the most advanced countries in the world. They kill their own citizens with directed energy and acoustic weapons.
Surveillance systems. Surveillance can be done through the smart meter with a chip that coordinates a wireless sensor network. Radar surveillance is performed with a system called multiple input, multiple outputs, with radio and camera nodes in a phased array which can be coordinated from aircraft. The brain can be controlled and entrained to receive and transmit information like a radio transceiver. If you have ringing in your left ear, you may already be connected to a communications network, including satellite.
Community-oriented policing services. The new proactive, intelligence-led policing, which means information gathered from surveillance devices in your home and vehicle, from your emails, phone calls, bank account, and online activity, allows fusion centers to direct global law enforcement goals, which means there are no expenses for trials, just harass and kill whoever you want, including the regulation of non-criminal conduct, which means punishment with electromagnetic and acoustic weapons, and the provisions of services neighborhood watch gangstalkers call cohorts or watchers. Many targeted individuals are handicapped or on Medicaid, Medicare. The state is deciding who the undesirables are, literally who lives and who dies. This has happened before. Modern terrorists may be those who have witnessed crimes of police, firemen, or paramedics enter underground societies with private agendas, who steal everything people own, eliminate their rivals, and kill anyone who knows or sees. They radiate and gangstalk targeted individuals mercilessly until they're dead. How does voice-to-skull or V2K happen? The sounds normally heard by our ears are between 20 Hz and 20 kHz. The sounds you can't hear that are used for V2K are either below or above that. In normal hearing, vibrating sound waves in the ear are turned into nerve impulses that travel along a network of nerve cells to the brain, where they are perceived as sound and turned into understandable speech. With V2K, a voice is carried on a frequency which is sent to the auditory cortex in the brain, bypassing the ears as if the brain were a radio receiver. Brain frequencies can be received and transmitted just like your cell phone picks up signals from a cell tower. The frequencies can be relayed to a satellite, so once you're connected, a person with a satellite computer can program the frequencies with auditory and visual information sent to your brain with special software and the internet using ordinary radio and television carrier frequencies. There are various companies like Microwave Radio Communications, which designs, markets, and sells wireless solutions to military markets. This kind of equipment can be used to program the torture system, which connects you to satellite surveillance. You can be remotely tortured and mind-controlled from a distance. Entire populations can be enslaved with this technology. Your thoughts can be read, and messages can be put into your mind so that your thoughts and actions are not your own. You become a slave. The 2003 article entitled Geoslavery by Jerome Dobson and Peter Fisher stated possible human rights abuse from the misuse of satellite targeting and surveillance technologies. Geoslavery is a practice in which one entity, the master, coercively or surreptitiously monitors and exerts control over the physical location of another individual, the slave. The article describes a scenario of monitoring and remote control by administering arbitrary punishment. Right now, someone high in power makes the decision that the victim, the targeted individual, needs to suffer torture, pain, and death by shocking, burning, cramping, and disintegration of their physical body with directed energy weapons. Removing skin seems to be a theme among masters. This is a picture of slaves who had their skin removed by their masters in Tibet. Why did they record brain frequencies from the back of the head? Probably because they don't think you'll notice, but there may be another reason. Alpha waves are strongest over the occipital cortex and over the frontal cortex. The alpha rhythm, 8 to 14 Hz, is most prominent when the subject is at rest with the eyes closed. When the eyes are open, this rhythm usually disappears, being replaced by beta rhythms, 14 to 35 Hz, a phenomenon called alpha blocking. The observation of this alpha blocking phenomenon is evidence that a high quality EEG is in fact being monitored. The The visual cortex is located in the occipital lobe in the back of the brain and processes visual information. One form of harassment is bypassing the eyes and sending pictures directly to the brain or recording visual information from your brain. This technology may use implants, which is also part of the harassment scenario. Some implants are used to induce constant pain or monitor and track the target.
Entrainment. Brain waves are affected by all our senses, and whatever a person is experiencing will affect their current brainwave state. And with the technology being used, they can get your specific frequencies, change them, and then send them directly back to your brain with a message carried on the frequency. This way they can alter your brain abilities, feelings, and personality one hertz at a time. This is an electroencephalogram demonstrating entrainment for 10 hertz. Entrainment also includes the concept that even if their frequency stopped being directed at you, the brain continues to operate at the same frequencies. Normally, brainwave entrainment is used to induce concentration, meditation, lucid dreaming, superlearning, sleep, and other desirable states, but as a weapon, the worst is possible. If sounds are consistent enough and are close to normal brainwave frequencies, then the brain will synchronize its own electrical impulses to the same rhythm. The government's most powerful EEG machines can enhance EEG patterns up to 200,000 times. Gain capability. They can be used to silently induce and change the emotional state in a human being using mechanical, magnetic, or optical media for repeated transmission to the brain of the victim. This is Lowry, patent 51597. This process is called induced alpha to theta biofeedback cluster movement. Silent sound makes machines that produce frequencies for mind control. An emotion signature cluster is identified and then placed on a silent sound carrier frequency to trigger the same basic emotion to another human being. The victim can't hear the subliminal message and is unaware why they are feeling anger, fear, or anxiety or another emotion.
This is the Colorado shooter, James Holmes. He appears to be mind-controlled. In the first picture, he appears to be normal. In the second picture, he looks a little robotic. In the third picture, he looks absolutely psychotic. These changes in personality indicate mind control with frequencies and/or drugs. Patents for this technology. This is the Robert G. Malik patent, remote neural monitoring, apparatus and method for remotely monitoring and altering brainwaves. Brain waves of a subject are sensed from a remote position. Two different frequencies are simultaneously transmitted to the brain where they interfere with one another to yield a waveform which is modulated by the subject's own brain waves. The waveform can produce a compensating signal which is transmitted back to the brain to affect a desired change in electrical activity therein. Infrastructure double duty. The technology of remote control of brain functions operates in the range between 3 Hz and 300 GHz. VLFs from 3 kHz are the instruments of telecommunications of most countries, so the instruments can perform their official duties and their unofficial modification of brain functions remotely.
On radio frequency hearing effect, method and device for implementing the radio frequency hearing effect. A frequency sends a thermal acoustic signal in the bone tissue material of the head and conducts the signal to the inner ear where it is converted to nerve signals which are sent to the brain, thereby enabling a voice to be heard by the brain the same as any other nerve signal from the cochlea. 2. Microwave hearing effect. Hearing system. Sound is induced in the head of a person by radiating the head with microwaves in the range of 100 to 10,000 megahertz that are modulated with a particular waveform to create the sensation of hearing in the person whose head is irradiated. Ultrasound. Acoustic heterodyne device. What else can they do with your frequency? Two ultrasound beams or frequencies are produced which cancel each other where they intersect. This is called heterodyning. The cancellation leaves the carried audible sound perceivable within the ear canal. Sound may be heard from across the room in midair or reflecting from any surface.
This can make popping sounds and voices in midair with no persons present. What else can be done with your frequencies? An assault with frequencies can do such things as erase your memory, give you new memories, change your personality and behavior, or make you feel uncontrollable physical and emotional pain. There are frequencies to make you feel angry, depressed, or anxious. Others manipulate the autonomic system, such as heart rate, sexual arousal, salivation, respiratory rate, and urination. It is possible to control the organs of the parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system with frequencies. Frequencies are being used to make targeted individuals lose control of their bowels or to stop the ability to urinate, requiring permanent intubation with a catheter. Some other torture effects are restless leg syndrome, points of pressure walking on your bed, loud snaps in mid-air, sounds in your attic, balls of light that appear on the ceiling, cramping of feet and toes angled upward, shocks to the body, involuntary movement or jerking, irregular heartbeat, and sexual assault. There are others. Sexual assault is performed by drugging a person or by massaging the sexual organs with a frequency. One couple was drugged and the woman raped by an intruder right beside her husband.
Can the electromagnetic energy be seen and recorded? A spectrum analyzer can read multiple frequencies at the same time. Also, the spectrum analyzer can measure audio, magnetic, radio, and microwave frequencies. A spectrum analyzer can show the same frequency in different ways. Patents for target tracking, human identification, radio and microwave hearing, emotion control, mind reading, remote neural monitoring, hypnosis, subliminal messaging, involuntary vocalization, remote nervous system excitation, and others are at skizit.biz.
There are atrocities going on in various countries. Some torture people with nails driven into their brains. Some are used for sex and then thrown away. And then there are the most advanced countries in the world. They kill their own citizens with directed energy and acoustic weapons.